Peter State Law, and this is
Amin Free.
This is
Ryan, and here's my brother
Adam.
Hey. When one object exerts a force on a second object, the second exerts a force on the first. That is equal in magnitude, but opposite in direction.
Newton's third law is describing how when you apply force to an object, a force with the same exact size will act on you in the opposite direction. This is called action reaction forces. When lifting an object, it accelerates upwards because the force of your hand is greater than the force of gravity.
Here are two examples of Newton's third law. The first example is of a bouncy ball, and the second is of a bike. Each illustration shows how force is applied to an object with an action, and another force occurs in the opposite direction as a reaction. In the first free body diagram, there is a ball being bounced. The ball has two forces being applied to it. The normal force, upwards, and the force of gravity, downwards. As the ball hits the floor, it causes a downwards motion. The floor reacts with the same amount of force in the opposite direction, propelling the ball upward. On a bike, there is the force of gravity and the normal force acting on it. According to Newton's third law, there is also a force being applied and a force reacting on the bike. As you pedal the bike, you apply a force moving backward. The ground also pushes on the tires with the same amount of force in the opposite direction, forward. This is a pair of action-reaction forces. Due to the size of the Earth, the force applied to it does not move the Earth backward. However, the force applied to the bike moves it forward.